welcome back for another episode of Think on This. Happy to be with you again. I am going through 1 John chapter 2, and I'm going to be reading 18 through 25 today, those verses. It says, "Children, it is the last hour, and as you have heard that Antichrist is coming, so now many Antichrists have come. Therefore, we know that it is the last hour. They went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would have continued with us. But they went out that it might become plain that they are not of us." They all are not of us. "But you have been anointed by the Holy One, and you all have knowledge. I write to you not because you do not know the truth, but because you know it, and because no lie is of the truth. Who is the liar but he who denies that Jesus is the Christ? This is the Antichrist, he who denies the Father and the Son. No one who denies the Son has the Father. Whoever confesses the Son has the Father also. Let what you heard from the beginning abide in you. If what you heard from the beginning abides in you, then you too will abide in the Son and in the Father. And this is the promise that he made to us, eternal life." Now, when John refers to the last hour, he's talking about the imminent return of Jesus Christ. You know, he could come back at any time, and we don't know exactly when. If you look at passages in the Bible, many Christians, even in those days, had anticipated Jesus would return in their lifetime. The Apostle Paul makes mention of it, especially what was going on during the Roman Empire. When you try to categorize what the last days are, there's a lot of persecution, there's a lot of war, and a lot of that was going on in that time. So there have been people all throughout history who have fit the description of Antichrist. Though they fit that description, this person is going to be a spokesperson of the devil himself. It's a scary thought. Now, if Jesus could come in the next 30 years, it's possible that this person is living on earth now. And if Jesus was to come in the next 5 years, it is possible that this person is active in government right now. Now, regardless of the speculations on when Jesus will return and who the Antichrist might be, one thing we know for sure is that we have an obligation to spread the truth, an incentive even more needed now than ever. We need to tell people about the gospel. We need to take a stand against false teachers. John says they came out of us, but they were not of us. You know, this is referring to people who had a false profession of faith, that did not possess the Father because they did not believe in the Son. They denied the truth of Jesus Christ. And there are many people in the name of Christianity who claim Christianity, but they say nothing of Jesus coming to save people from their sins, and in essence, they deny Jesus because of why he came. It's so watered down, it's so diluted with the philosophies of the world that there's no gospel left, not even a hint of it, and it's very sad, and it's affecting, I hate to say it, it's affecting, you know, right here at home even. We need to be mindful of that. We need to take a stand against it because people are sincerely believing they're doing the right thing, participating in these churches, listening to these false teachers, but they're sincerely wrong. And, you know, maybe some of them are saved. I can't speak for that. But when you look at what's coming out of the pulpit in a lot of the churches in America today, it's not gospel and it's not Christ-centered and it's leading people away. So John says that these people have a false profession of faith. They don't possess the Father. They do not believe in the Son. They deny the truth of Jesus Christ. Now, if you understand salvation, you understand that we are all sinners, and that we need a Savior, and that Jesus was the one who paid that sin debt that humanity owed God the Father. If we call on Jesus to save us, if we repent of our sin and believe and call on him, we will have eternal life. But anyone who is preaching a message contrary to this, anyone who doesn't say this, is a false teacher. You know, there I can think of a number of examples. The Signs and Wonders movement, the people who lay hands on you and you're healed and all that, slap you on the forehead, that type of stuff. You know, it's funny how all that stuff's done in a contained environment, but in light of the pandemic, you know, all these people who claim to be miraculous healers, and I hate giving names, but one person that comes to my mind is Kenneth Copeland, who is one of the biggest false teachers, one of the biggest heretics in a modern day in the modern day charismatic movement. You know, if this pandemic is you know, something that is just another thing you can just blow away. I don't know if any of you saw that video. You know, why are these faith healers not going out and healing all these sick people? Now, I know there's a whole lot of other stuff to be said about the pandemic now. Here we are in September or August of 2020, and it's been a lot of things that came to light that have opened our eyes to a lot of even government agencies misleading us on certain things. But to stay on the topic at hand with false teachers and all that, why aren't all these people who claim to be miracle workers and healers going out and actually eradicating the viruses? Because they can't. They can't. They've misinterpreted scripture so grossly that they've developed for themselves a practice that's not feasible in the current situation they're in, and now they're paying the price for it. And unfortunately, there is still a huge following. If you're being deceived by these people, then, you know, God help you. You need to open your eyes and get into God's truth and see it for what it is. You know, anyone who's preaching a message contrary to the gospel and to what the Bible says is a false teacher, and we should not lend our ears to such people. Many people have been swayed, many people are swayed, and will be swayed, and they'll never hear the truth. It's unfortunate. Personally, if I believe what I say, if you believe what you're reading from the Bible, we need to be vigilant. You know, this is a challenge here. Be vigilant to share the gospel with others. This is imperative because people are on their way to hell right now, not realizing because they don't know the truth of the gospel. They've been led astray to the point that they've never heard the truth. Their only hope is Jesus. They need his saving grace. There's nothing that this world offers in exchange for your soul once it's over with. There is no second chance. There is no chance in eternity to change your destiny. This is Rob Caudill with Think on This. Thank you for watching.